Is the Bitcoin ETF getting listed this week? Why is there no interest for Ethereum? And great news for XRP. That and more in the Crypto Market Talk this week. In this week's episode, we will talk about Bitcoin because we have some interesting news, maybe even already this week. Then we will talk quickly about Ethereum and have a look at the chart there as well. And at the end, we'll quickly talk about some great news around Ripple. Let's first start, of course, with the elephant in the room. Let's start with this news right here. Bitcoin is pumping. Crazy daily candle in the last 24 hours. We'll look at the chart in just a second. A lot of people are asking, why is Bitcoin pumping? And it's because of this. The iShares Spot Bitcoin Trust is listed on the Depository Trust and Clearing Corporation. The SEC has accepted the rule change to list and trade shares of the Grayscale Ethereum Futures Trust as well. We'll jump into that news story right away. But right now, it does look like we might get an approval fairly early. The Depository Trust and Clearing Corporation is this one step before ETFs are getting listed on the NASDAQ. So essentially, it is a step before that. We can already look for the iBTC short code and we can find the product there with some descriptions and a title. So it does look like it might even be approved fairly soon, and people are already doing the preparations for that. In terms of numbers, what happened because of this positive news in the last 24 hours, we've seen around $400 million in crypto liquidations. A lot of people from the short end have given up their money to the long traders. The Ether futures, however, only made about $50 million in terms of trading volume when it came to the liquidations. So the majority is still betting on Bitcoin going down. Now, will Bitcoin go down due to geopolitical crises? We don't know yet. What we do know, however, is the following news as well. Grayscale court victory over SEC in spot Bitcoin ETF case is made final. We talked about this a couple of weeks ago. Grayscale won essentially in the court against the SEC. So there was no reason for the SEC to decline the essentially the Bitcoin spot ETF that they wanted to bring out. And since then, this decision has been made final, and that in turn means Grayscale will reapply for a spot ETF. Now, they might be too late already because, again, BlackRock and the iShares product might be earlier than the Grayscale product, or all of them will get approved at once. We will find out fairly soon. But if we look at this chart right here, you can see it already. Huge daily candle here. That jump was pretty much out of nowhere. We already increased to around 28,000, and then this thing jumped up until 34 to 35,000, depending on the exchange. Since then, it has kind of recovered a bit. We're still sitting at a solid 34,000. And again, will it hold up? That's the big question. We usually expect kind of a retouch of this resistance that we've just broken. So I expect a retouch of around 32,000. If this breaks once again, then probably it was just this short-lived expectation. And otherwise, I would say it will probably touch the 32 and then go up higher, especially if the news will come out and will be positive. I do expect this to go higher as well. Now, next up, we have Ethereum staking. Ethereum staking is in a weird place. On one side, we have the validator queue, which we talked about last week. It is drying up. It has even reached zero on a specific date in October. And remember, in July, there was a wait time of around 35 to 45 days in terms of validator queue. Since then, it has gone to zero. And right now, we're looking at a very low interest when it comes to Ethereum as well. The reward has also dropped from its June peak of 5.2% to 3.5% today per beacon chain. So that means staking Ethereum is not as attractive as it used to be. Is it a flaw in the system? That is the big question, because you remember About 1 year ago, Ethereum switched from proof of work to proof of stake. And right now we're looking at lower kind of interest rates or interest rate numbers. You can look at this as a dividend, of course, depending on your kind of jurisdiction. It is not meant as a dividend, but this is essentially how the network is working. So they're getting paid a specific ETH amount for staking your Ethereum. Looking at the chart, we can also see an interesting daily candle here as well. Again, also fairly high jump, of course, maybe not in the double digits as Bitcoin, but fairly high at 1,000, almost 1,900, but hasn't touched it really. I would expect this to go down. However, the retouch here should be a bit lower, maybe 1,746 before we can go higher. So probably kind of touching 1,746 and then the price would go up higher as well. Talking about the SEC, let's talk about this here. Ripple's case in summer was also huge news for the XRP token. And the SEC then said they will actually appeal the decision and we could expect kind of another trial or something else in court. However, the SEC has dropped the charges against Ripple CEO Garlinghouse and Chairman Larson. So it does look like the entire XRP situation is cleaned up. And that, of course, means positive, very positive news for XRP, the token. Let's have a look at the price here. And what we can see clearly is there is a bigger trend here going. Of course, we've had some excellent positive news here with the different kind of trials and jury cases, etc. But right now it is looking like XRP wants to go higher. This, of course, was when the XRP case was essentially dropped or decided against that there was no case. Since then, it has come down, touched this trend line once again, and it has gone sideways. So it is looking like there is a channel opening here up as well. So we will probably have to trade this until kind of a retouch of the trend line, and then we'll probably go up as well. That was it from the crypto market talk this week. Make sure that you subscribe to not miss any other crypto news. I will see you in the next one. Have a good one.